Hey guys, welcome back. My name is Tammy Sanders from the blog Learning and Teaching with Preschoolers. So in today's episode, I wanted to give you a time-saving tip that you'll love once you get used to using Trello. So if you've seen some of my other episodes, you know I'm a Trello user. It keeps me organized. It's kind of like a lesson planner, Pinterest board, kind of all wrapped into one, and I can have these different boards going on that I can use in different ways. So I love Trello to keep me organized for my small groups, because if you're like me, you change your kids around kind of frequently based on their needs and where they need to grow. And sometimes for social skills, you might put them somewhere else or whatever the reason is for you moving children around. So I used to handwrite all my kids down. When you have 40 kids in one group and you're moving them around, it takes a long time to kind of reshuffle and redo it. So in Trello, I can just simply move cards around and slide them back and forth to where I want them, which saves me a lot of time from writing list after list after list. And sometimes I'll put my list somewhere and I'll go, I know I moved such and such to this group, but what group did I move them to? I can't remember. And then I can't find my list. So then I kind of have to start over again. So in order to save all of that, I started using Trello this year, and it is a game changer. So let me flip the camera around so you can see how I'm using Trello to meet the needs of planning out my small group, my children within those groups. Sure makes it a lot simpler. Okay, so here's all of my boards that I have for Trello. So today we're going to be talking about small groups. So if I click on my small group board, you can see that I have different groups. So here's all the names of children that I need to put into a group, and then here's all of my groups. But the great thing about it is I can switch these kids back and forth wherever I need them. So if I want Wendy to go over here to the blue group because that's a better fit for her now, I can come in and I can relabel it. So she is in my blue group now, and I can get rid of this one because I don't want her in the yellow anymore. And boom, there she is. I don't have to rewrite anything. And then I might go, oh, you know what, Joaquin over here, I'm gonna put him in the yellow group. I can label him as yellow group so he stands out in my list and I know where he's at. So see how much simpler that is for me just to move him around. And pretty much that's all I do with this board. I might put their levels in there, because in here you can put notes on here where you might have done a math assessment. So you might have did math, level, whatever level you have, reading, level, whatever. And if you're wanting to do them by level, you have their level information there of where you feel they would best be served in whatever group you want to move them to. But basically, I mostly use it for just the flexibility of me being able to move them back and forth into whatever group I want. I can change out their labels very simply by simply just clicking on labels and moving them to whatever group. I want to say this might have been orange, not sure where I had them at just now. So it just makes it, I put them to red. To red group. So it just makes it a lot simpler for moving my children back and forth. It saves me a lot of time when I want to reshuffle my group and I want my girls to know who is in each group. So here's all the names of my kids, and then these are all the colors of my different groups that I have in my classroom. So if you haven't tried Trello yet, I'm telling you, it is a really great organizational system for the classroom. Give it a try, guys. Bye.